Alright folks, so Claude Opus 4.5 has been released by Anthropic, and here's the benchmark that you will be seeing flying around, and it is truly quite impressive. But I'll show you what's more impressive. It was able to one-shot this entire arcade game simulator from a single prompt using cursor. Alright, so you can see it has sound effects, it has lots of details. When I press up and down, you can see this little joystick moving, and you can see it has full mechanics of all of the games working. Alright, so it has a breakout game over here. Alright, and then it has snake. So cool. Yep. And you can hear that. And it literally looks really good as well. So it isn't just a very basic looking snake game. It actually does have all of the visual effects. So you can see the glowing animated food items. And then Space Invaders over here as well. Alright. Right. And the mechanics are working. So you can see the AI of the Space Invaders are also there. And then I'm gonna be able to shoot them. Oof. And yeah, you can see I'm not very good at this game. And even Tetris, the full game of Tetris working with all of the mechanics, so I can clear rows. All right, and that's where it is. Yep, so you can see the row clearing is working fine. The ghost prediction of where it's going to land is also working fine. And let's see if I can get a decent score here. There you go. All right, so you can see all of it is working. And like I said, I just fired it up with the cursor. And all I did was that I just went into plan mode using Opus 4.5, and then after that, when it created the plan, I used build mode as well. So here you go. I'm just going to scroll all the way up and I'll show you this. So this was the prompt that I used, and I'll be putting the prompt into the description as well as the source code of this. But this was a single prompt that I used, and it was able to build this entire thing. If you look at this compared to Opus 4.1, the last state of the art, it's actually cheaper by a third. So this is just a crazy move, because a lot of people were expecting Opus 4.5 to be really good at what it does, but going to cost a bomb. But in this case, there's absolutely no reason to be using 4.1 anymore. Alright, so here we go within Cursor. I'm going to start off on a completely fresh repository. So the first thing you want to do is just to select Opus 4.5. Okay, and you can see it is available at solid 4.5 cost during these first 2 weeks. And I'm going to go and switch into plan mode, and I'm going to be using Whisperflow so that I can just dictate what I want without having to type it out. If you want to check it out, I've got a link in the description below as well. Okay, so let's get started. So look, I just want to build a very simple app. Build me an app where I can upload an image, and what it will do is that it will create a voxelized version of the image as if it's made up of Lego bricks, obviously of the same size. And what I want is that I should be able to pan around in 3D space, and if I press space bar, it should explode the pieces into their individual pieces with a nice visual effect. Ensure that the web page looks ensure that the entire page looks visually pleasing and appealing. Ensure that it's clear how to interact with the system. Okay, so that's the prompt that we have there, and I'm just going to go into plan mode. So the thing that you will see about Opus is that, not right now, not in plan mode, but when we go into the implementation mode, it will keep going and going and going. The reason why I'm using Cursor is because it is having a promotion right now. All right, and I recently downgraded from Claude Code. I actually recently downloaded Claude Code from Max to Pro, so I don't actually have access to Opus 4.5 yet, which now makes me think that I probably should upgrade back to Max. But there are other ways that you can access it, such as through Cursor, as you see here, or you can use it through WAP, and you can check that out in one of my previous videos as well. But anyway, let's just jump back into this. So you can see here, it's come up with the plan for the implementation. And usually what you want to do is switch to something that is fast, like Composer 1 or GPT 5.1 Codex, or even Haiku, which I don't actually see right here, but it doesn't matter. But given that Opus 4.5 is going at Sonnet 4.5 price, it's a no-brainer to just use it right now. Okay, so let's just go and build this, and let's see what the end result will look like. And like I showed earlier, this Pixel Palace game was entirely one-shotted with all the visual effects, sound effects, and everything. So sometimes when you go into plan mode, it will actually ask you specific questions before it moves on to finalizing the plan. In this case, it didn't. It seems that it has a clear enough idea. So now what we're going to do is that we're just going to look at the to-dos that you have here, and it's going to run through all of them. And like I mentioned earlier, from what I've seen so far in my previous run, Opus 4.5 is really good at agentic steps and going on and on until it reaches the end state, which in the case of the previous demo was really good. The end state was really good. But I'm really keen to see if this is going to be able to get to the result that I want, because it's a little bit less defined, right? Or maybe the prompt that I use isn't the best, but I'm still really quite interested to see how well this does. So we'll draw back when this is done, and then I will take a look at the end result and see whether or not this works. This is the first time I'm running this prompt. It was an idea that that came to my head. I actually did build a similar app a few days ago using Gemini, but let's see how Opus 4.5 does. All right, so we'll draw back once this finishes and we'll see how it does. Okay, so I wanted to show you how it's progressing, and here's one of the reasons why using Cursor is really good. It's because when it is testing the app that you created, which you can see over here, it has its own browser, and within it, it will continuously do things where it would try to capture screenshots. So you can see it's captured a screenshot of it over here. And so here you can see this is another screenshot of it with a loaded image. And this is just one of those things where it really makes the development experience very intuitive, because you can see the end result and not just look at the code that's being generated. And you can see it can also do browser action. So you can press spacebar, and then it can capture the screenshot when it presses spacebar. And then you can see down here, it's actually talking about the explosion animation. So this looks really cool, right? Just take a look at this right here. This is what happens when it explodes. And then it was also doing a reassembly as well. This is one of the reasons why Cursor provides a really good experience. And one of the reasons why I've actually come back to using Cursor quite a bit is because of these browser tools. And I actually did a video getting up to speed on Cursor 2.0. And this was one of the main reasons and main draw of like using Cursor a lot more again. Anyway, you can see this is working fine. And so I do have an image over here. So let's see if that works. Yep. All right. So you can see this is a voxelized as if it's made out of Lego. And I can explode it by pressing spacebar, I think. And there we go. All right. So it's completely exploded and then it's reassembled again. And that's pretty cool. This is what I asked for. And I think this end result is just really cool.
All right.
And I'm really impressed with it. This was entire thing was just building one shot. So it explodes and then reassembles again. So that's really cool. And one of the reasons why Opus 4.5 is just really impressive. Yeah, just wanted to do this quick video playing around with it. So let's just, and looking forward to running even more tests with this. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like this video, hit subscribe for more great AI content, and don't forget to turn on notifications so that you're always the first to know whenever new content like this drops.